See, today we have to look into the reports, right? Put heading in the notes, please. Reports. Reports. All the reports. All the reports are organized. All the reports are organized in the information systems folder. In the information systems folder of SAP Easy Access. In the information systems folder of SAP Easy Access. In that folder, the reports are organized according to the modules and submodules under the subfolder accounting, under the subfolder accounting. Look at the screen, please. Here, this is the SAP Easy Access. Here, this is the information folder. So, information systems folder. So, in this folder, all the reports have been organized. See, in this information systems folder, you have the subfolder accounting. So, under the accounting subfolder, the reports are organized according to modules and submodules. For example, if you click on this accounting, there is financial accounting, right? Treasury, controlling, real estate management, consolidation, right? Then in the financial accounting, you have the general ledger, accounts receivable, accounts payable, fixed assets. So these are the general ledger reports are available in the general ledger subfolder. The reports of account receivable are available in the account receivable subfolder, accounts payable subfolder. Here, the execution of every report is very, very simple in SAP. For example, I want to draw trial balance. See, in the normal accounting, before preparing the financial statements, it is mandatory to prepare the trial balance. Unless the trial balance is tallied, you cannot assume the correctness of your books of accounts. So, trial balance is the list of account balances prepared to ensure the arithmetical accuracy of the postings. That is mandatory in the manual accounting. But in SAP, the preparation of trial balance is not mandatory because, as I said, the purpose of preparing trial balance is to ensure the arithmetical accuracy of the postings. Means to ensure that for every debit, there was a corresponding equal credit, and for every credit, there is corresponding equal debit. So this is the accounting principle. So at the time of posting the transactions in SAP, if the debit is not equal to credit, or if the credit is not equal to debit, it will not allow us to post, right? In that case, it's not mandatory to prepare the trial balance. But even though it is not mandatory, still it is advisable to prepare the trial balance, because through the trial balance, we can find out if there are any balances of any GL accounts or vendor accounts or customer accounts to be written off. That's why we prepare the trial balance. So here, preparing trial balance is very, very simple, right? Just to write down the path for this trial balance, put heading preparation of trial balance. Preparation of trial balance. Path. SAP Easy Access, SAP Easy Access, Accounting, Accounting, Information Systems, I'm sorry, SAP Easy Access, no, we have to start CO tomorrow. CO was not at started, CO will be started tomorrow. See, I gave you the wrong path by mistake, because I was searching in the path for something else, right? Please write down the path for trial balance. SAP Easy Access, Information Systems, Accounting, Financial Accounting, General Ledger, Information Systems, Account Balances, Korea, Trial Balance, South Korea, Transaction code S_ALR_870-12310. So here these reporting transaction codes will contain 14 characters. Chart of accounts is equal to 3366. Company code is equal to 3366. Fiscal year 2017. Open items at key date is equal to 31st December 2017. So in our training company code, we can see the reports only for 2017. Click on execute. Ignore the warning message. See, this is the trial balance format. So the total, see here, GL account number, GL account long text, beginning balance, that is opening balance, period 16 debit, period 16 credit, accumulated value debit means total debit, then accumulated value credit means total credit, closing balance, currency. So this is the system different format of trial balance. But according to our normal format of trial balance, right, we don't have this beginning balance column, period 16 debit column, period 16 credit column. So we have the GL account or GL account long text and accumulated debit, accumulated credit, closing balance and currency. So currency also indeed we don't have, right? So in that case, we can remove the columns not required from the trial balance. But we cannot add the columns. We can remove the columns from the trial balance. So my requirement is not to have beginning balance, period 16 debit, period 16 credit. Right? In that case, how to remove these columns? Continue. To remove the columns, to remove the columns from the trial balance. Click on current layout icon. Click on current layout icon within brackets. Control plus F8. Look at the screen. One second. This one. This is called current layout. So here, displayed columns, column set. Select the columns not required. Select the columns not required. And transfer them. Select the columns not required. And transfer them from left side table to the right side table. From left side table to the right side table. Look at the screen. Here, I don't require beginning balance. Select this. So click on head selected field. I don't require PD 16 debit. Select this. Transfer it to right side. I don't require PD 16 credit. Select this. Transfer to right side field. Click on enter. Click on enter. See, GL account number, GL account long text, accumulated value debit, accumulated value credit, closing balance currency. So trial balance is tallied. Now, the thing is, one more thing. Here, I don't require the user Lakshman. Suppose you are going to submit this trial balance to your auditors, right? In that case, having all these columns is not correct, right? And one more thing, I want to have the heading trial balance of so-and-so company limited as on 31st December 2017. So that heading also I want to have, right? And I don't want all these fields, user Lakshman, program name, title, date, reporting, time frame. All these fields I don't want to have. Are you getting my point? Because it's this trial balance will not look clean, right? This trial balance will not look clean. And also, we don't have the trial balance of GE Infotech Incorporation as on 31st December 2017. So all these things are not there, right? So how to add those headings and how to remove these columns, right? They are not removing these columns from the report as such is not possible. But we can export this report or we can export this trial balance to the Excel sheet. So in the Excel sheet, you can do whatever the modifications you want, right? But how to send this trial balance to Excel sheet? Continue. Actually, I cannot show you the Excel sheet here because it's not properly linked with the server. Okay. So I will show you the path where we can take it to Excel sheet, right? Continue. To take the trial balance, no, it is a system, see, that format is compatible, right? According to your needs, that format is compatible. That's why I have shown you that Korea trial balance. There isn't any logic, Anil. To send the trial balance to Excel sheet, go to menu list, export, spreadsheet. Suppose if you want to send it to a CD or a flat file, in that case you click on local file. But here I want to send it to Excel sheet, right? Go to menu list, export, spreadsheet. select Excel, no, select Open Office. Not like that, because in HP 7 there was a little bit of change, it seems. Do one thing. You select from all available formats. Select from all available formats. Select Excel one, just one second, let me do first. HTML format. This is the problem we are getting, right? We found a problem with some content, export ODS. Do you want us to try recover as much as we can? If you touch the source of this workbook, click yes. So it seems that it's not properly configured, right? Excel was able to open the file by preparing or removing the unreadable content. Let us check. No. So this is the problem with the Excel. Excel was not properly connected with this SAP server, right? That is the reason why we are not able to see anything there. But it's not the case. The system will display the report in this Excel sheet, right? Then you can make your modifications. Write down. Go to menu list, export, spreadsheet. Then select from all available formats radio button. Select from all available formats radio button. Select from the drop down menu. Select from the drop down menu. Excel in Office 2003 XML format. Click on Enter. Click on Save. Click on Save. So here also it's not working. Right. So, but this is the way how we can export to Excel sheet. So not only trial balance, every report can be exported to trial balance in the same manner. Okay. So how to execute other reports? Just look at the screen. See, I want to display the line items of all the GL accounts. I want to display the line items of all the GL accounts. In that case, see, we have to come to the general ledger. Under the general ledger, we have to search for the reports, because it's not possible to tell you the paths, and it's not possible for us to remember the paths, because there are nearly more than 2000 reports are there, and all the reports may not be compatible for all the clients. Right? See, suppose for example, I want to display the account balances of all the GL accounts. In that case, you have to come to the path like information systems, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, information systems, account balances, general, GL account balances. See, yes, underscore ALR underscore 8701-2277. Chart of accounts 3366. GL accounts 1 to all 9s. Very simple, given the criteria. Company code 3366. Click on execute. See, for every GL account, balance carried forward 0. Balance in the previous period 0. Debit in the reporting period means total debit and credit in the reporting period. Accumulated balance. That's how we can display the balances of all the GL accounts in the one screen. Right? And if you go to menu list, you can take the printout. Okay? Now, click on back arrow. For example, I want to see average balances. So, there are many types of average balances. And it's not possible to understand every report, because SAP has configured all the reports from the requirements of almost all the countries. Suppose, for example, structured account balances. I will show you one important report. See, I want to take the printout of your journal. For a specific year, I want to take the printout of the journal, right? Means day book. Otherwise, I want to take the printout of yesterday's transactions. In that case, see, SAP Easy Access, it's very important report. Information systems, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, information system, document. General, document journal, just 1 second. Yes, document journal, again document journal, yes underscore ALR underscore 8701-2287. See, company code 3377, document number 1 to all 9s, fiscal year 2017, posting date 1/1/2017 to 31st December 2017. Means for the total year, I want to take the printout of the journal. Otherwise, I want to take the printout from 1st December 2017. Only for 1 month, I want to take the printout of the journal, right? Then click on execute. It is giving one message. See, you should select documents as of 1/1/2017. Otherwise, journal is incomplete. No issues. I want the journal only for 1 month, right? So in that case, give 1/12/2017 to 31st December 2017. Ignore the message. You see here. One second. Company code 3377. Okay. See here, date wise you can see. This is 29/12/2017. So again, you can take the printout here. Here, whatever the things you can do with this report are available in the list menu only. See, if you want to take the printout, you can click on printout. If you want to save, right, in Office or in a local file, you can go on save and send, right? So like that, you have to go through all these details, right? It's not possible to remember the paths also, okay? So this is one of the important report. Then, and all the reports relating to account receivable are available in the account receivable submodule. That is another type of format, nothing else. SAP minimal variant is another type of format. It's a different format. So if you want to see the reports, now I want to take the list of customers. I want to take the list of customers, right? In that case, you can use F.20. Or again, if you want to take the printout of account balances of all the customers, in that case, you just go to the account balances, give your customer number 1 to all names, company code 3666, execute. So customer account balances. See, for example, from the customer 1,301,000, you have to receive 4,75,000. Then from the customer 1,302,000, you have to receive 2,40,000. Clear, no? So like that, you can display the receivables in a list. How much amount you have to receive from each customer, that you can display in this report. Again, if you want to take the printout, go to menu list print. Similarly, open items. Customer account wise, I want to display open items, right? F.21. Customer account, 1 to all names. Very simple. Everywhere you have to give only the customer number and a company code. See, these are the open items for the customer Rajini Enterprises, right? And as on today, these are the open items. It shows including normal GL and special GL, right? Just observe all these reports clearly in your practice. Then, again, if you go to reports for accounts receivable recounting, there are many other reports. I want to take the list of customers along with their addresses, right? You can execute this report. Customer list. Customer 1 to all names. Company code 3666. Execute. So what is the customer name? His address. Here we did not maintain all these addresses, no? You maintain only customer name and numbers. Name and country, that's it. So it is showing only those customer number. Rajini Enterprises, Sujana Enterprises, etc., etc. So like that, similarly, if you want to see the reports in accounts payable, here all the account payable reports are there. One second. So like that, fixed assets reports are there in the fixed assets. That's how you can browse through all these reports. Okay. So with this, our FI is over. As I said, I will be sending you some other classes recordings, which are not there in your content. Like, for example, if you take accounts payable, you have the concept of noted items. And there are some other scenarios as far as advance are concerned. In our class, we have seen how to process if the advance are equal to invoice amount. But sometimes invoice amount will be more than the advance amount, and sometimes advance amount will be more than the invoice amount. In that case, how to process? What is the noted items? What are the one-time vendors? So these already have recorded. I just have to upload them. Then in accounts payable, sorry, account receivable, we have some other topic like, again, same advanced scenarios, then noted items, one-time customers, then cash journal, then cash discount paid configuration, then how to post sales returns. I did not show you the sales returns in the sales in our account receivable, and how to process bills of exchange. So these are the some of the topics, right, which you have not covered. So if I have to cover all these topics again in the class, it takes months together. So that's why what I thought was, right, I am recording these classes. Some of the recordings are over. Then I have to upload. So I have started this trend from your batch only, right? For the previous batches, I did not send all this content. Okay. So from your batch only, I have taken this decision to upload other topics also. But I will send the material like PPTs and the configuration material for those topics also. But only the thing is, you cannot download them. You can only listen to those recordings, and you can write on the material, and you can do the practice. So still 2-3 topics are pending, right? So once these 2-3 topics are also over, I will upload. So with that way, in that way, most of our 90% of FI is completed. In our class, we have covered, along with these further recordings, we have covered 90% of FI. So you will be very much perfect if you want to apply for the jobs only for FI. You need not worry about it. Akhila, you have any questions? Okay. Anil? No. You have the lifetime access, Chandrasekhar. For the videos, you have the lifetime access. Gadi? Okay. Khalid? Okay. Matsudan? Okay. Chandrasekhar? Okay. Tejasvi? I think Roni has gone offline. Roni? And today, along with the recording, I will send you the controlling material. I will check. I will try. Anil? So along with today's recording, I will send you the controlling material for tomorrow's class. Okay then, see you tomorrow same time.